In this video tutorial, we'll be diving into how to seamlessly send profiles from a linked helper directly to Google Sheets without the need for third-party tools. Firstly, make sure you have a Google Sheets document ready. You need to rename the sheet to LH, or if you want to name it differently, you can adjust the code later accordingly. Now, head over to Extensions, Apps Script. In the Code menu, we need to replace the code with the one provided in our knowledge base. To find it, you can click on Knowledge Base in the left side ribbon in Link Helper. Start typing Google to find the relevant article, and here it is, how to integrate Link Helper with Google Sheets directly. Scroll down till you see a piece of code and copy all of it. Now go back to Google Sheets app script and paste this code here. If you used a different sheet name, modify line 17 of the script. Replace the LH part with the name of your sheet. Great! Now click the plus button next to the Services menu. Scroll to Google Sheets API and click Add. Now it's time to deploy. Click Deploy, select New Deployment, choose Web App, give description, and ensure access is set to anyone. Click Deploy. Don't forget to authorize access when prompted. In the pop-up window, click on the Google account which spreadsheet you will be using. Click Advanced and then go to the Untitled Project. If you gave your project a title, the name will be different. Once access is allowed and the project is deployed, copy the web app URL. Now, back in the linked helper campaign, let's add the send person to webhook action. I want to send profiles who accepted my invitation request, and also I want to see the full data, so I've added visit and extract action right after the filter. Click Add action and select send person to webhook. Paste the web app URL. Configure your action settings, set the number of columns you want to send to the spreadsheet. You can also enable sending messaging history if needed and allowed by your license type. And ensure you are converting data as needed. Switch on these two buttons. Save and close. When you insert an action in between, and there are no profiles in the queue of the action below, you can find profiles that have been already processed by the lower action in the skipped sublist and send them to a spreadsheet anyway. Start your campaign and voila! Profiles will be sent directly to your Google Sheets document. A webhook to Google Sheets can be set for replied profiles too. Send replied to webhook plugin can help you to stay on top of your interactions. Before we dive into the setup, note that with the standard license, messaging history cannot be sent via webhook. But for Pro license users, there is no such limitation. Switch on the toggle here. The URL to a spreadsheet that we created before was added here. But I want to send data with replies to a new sheet inside the same document. So let's go back to Google Sheets and create a new sheet. I'm going to name it LH Replied. Go to Apps Script and click plus button over here to create a new script. Copy the piece of code from our knowledge base again and change the name of the sheet in the code in line 17. In my case, it's LH Replied. Now, to deploy the app, repeat the steps as the first time. Now go back to Link Helper and replace the webhook URL in the send replies to the webhook settings. Adjust the number of columns sent according to your needs and leave convert data to flat objects and convert multi-line values into single line switched on. All set, and I want to send already found replies to the sheet. So I need to retry profiles from the replied sublist. Start the campaign and wait a few minutes to let Link Helper detect and send replies to Google Sheets. If you don't want to send certain fields, simply delete the relevant columns. You can analyze this data by means of Excel functions. I'm going to show you how to determine how many profiles replied among those who were invited in November. As you can see, I used automatic tags to mark certain profiles. So now I can quickly calculate the number of profiles with this specific tag, invited November 23, among all the replied. To do this, I need the COUNTIF function. It goes like this. Now, highlight the range you want to analyze, tags column in my case, and then type the criteria, the condition you are looking for. Done! And there you have it, a seamless integration between Link Helper and Google Sheets, all without the need for third-party tools. If you find this tutorial helpful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more content. Until next time, happy connecting on LinkedIn!